ओपन एरिया फ्लोर बेडिंग. नाउ यू हैव लर्न्ड अबाउट फ्लोर अंडर शेडेड एरिया. इफ यू हैव अ टाई सिस्टम फार्म देन यू विल नॉट हैव एन ओपन एरिया. बट इफ यू हैव अ लूज हाउसिंग सिस्टम देन यू विल नीड टू लर्न अबाउट द फ्लोर इन द ओपन एरियाज. इन योर फार्म इन द ओपन एरिया द मैन्योर स्प्रेड्स एंड बिकम ड्राई ड्यू टू एनिमल मूवमेंट एंड सनलाइट. द ड्राई पाउडर्ड फॉर्म मैन्योर एक्ट एज अ गुड बेडिंग मटेरियल फॉर डेयरी एनिमल्स. When any animal sits on such dry manure bedding, there is no pressure on the udder and teat orifices do not stay open. This reduces the incidences of subclinical mastitis. During rains, the manure will need to be removed daily. In other times of the year, you will not need to remove the manure. This will reduce your labor cost. In the open floor, if you have stones, then it may lead to injuries to the animal. Hence, you have to remove them out of your farm. In open areas, you should ensure that water does not get stagnated at any time. If the open area has only soil, then it may become very soft during the rains. Hence, when you construct the farm, you will need to put a layer of smooth pebbles or murum on the floor. Manure covers the stone layer and makes it hard over a period of time. Drains must be constructed on either side of the milking and feeding area and lead to the main drain that connects to the manure pit. The drain should be 1.5 feet wide and 6 to 8 inches deep without any sharp edges to avoid injuries to the animals. B. Manger. A concrete feed manger has to be constructed where feed and fodder is served to animals. The manger will be 60 feet in length, 2 feet wide and 1.5 feet deep at the center. It should be elevated 1 foot from the ground. In low-cost farms up to 20 animals, you can use concrete pipes which can be cut into two pieces. The pipes are 16 feet in length and 2 feet wide. The depth of pipe is 1 foot after cutting the pipe. You can keep the pipe on the ground or prepare a stand made out of cement or steel and place the pipe above it. This is the cheapest way of creating a manger where feed can be given to the animals. At the base of the manger, iron rings can be fitted at every 3 feet distance. The rings can be used to tie the animals while milking. If the farm is loose housing farm and the entire farm is not covered with shade, during rains the animals can be brought under the shade and tied to the manger so that they do not venture out in the rains. If you have a single shade and a one-sided manger, then to prevent rainwater from coming inside the manger, you can cover the side with a curtain. The distance between two mangers in a double shade should be at least 6 feet so that small tractor can move in the alley. C. Water. If you go to many existing dairy farms which do not have loose housing system, they do not have water troughs fitted on mangers. How will the animals get water when they are thirsty? If they don't get water, it will affect the health of animals. That's why dairy animals should get ample amounts of fresh and clean water at all times. While providing water, you have to take care of few things. Firstly, water should be available to animals 24 hours in a day and should be easily accessible. If you have made compartments, then each compartment should have two water troughs. They can be placed on opposite sides so that cows should be able to reach easily the water trough nearest to them. If any of the water troughs get empty or becomes defective, then the other trough can be used by the animals for some time. When a dairy animal gets 5 liters of water from different sources such as drinking water, green and dry fodder, etc., then it helps produce 1 liter of milk in the udder. Out of various sources, the easiest and most accessible source is drinking water. Secondly, to provide good quality water, you should coat the concrete water troughs with lime. After coating with lime, you should keep the trough dry for 8 to 10 hours. Otherwise, the lime will get washed out. Lime will prevent growth of algae. You can also use troughs made of steel. If you have less space, do not have a loose housing system, and animals are tied, then you can build a water trough system in manger like this. See, here the animals can drink water when they are tied up. You should know how much water will be required for your farm, considering drinking and washing or cleaning and irrigation requirements. If cows get good quality water, the dairy animals are less affected by stress and will produce good quality and quantity of milk. Water storage tanks are required in every farm. If you have electricity problems in your farm, then you have to have a sufficient large tank so that you can use water for several days. From wherever you get water supply to the farm, you should verify whether this source will be able to provide water to your farm for the entire year. If not, then you should create an artificial pond to store the water supply. Here you can see a water pond. As per your water requirement, you can create your pond. For 6 months, if you have a water requirement of 7 lakh liters, then you need to create a pond of suitable size. You will also have to consider that evaporation rate of the water from open ponds. You have to line the bottom of the pond with 500 micron plastic sheet so that water does not seep down. By doing this, you will achieve water security for your farm. You need to check the water quality by measuring the total dissolvable solids, which is also called as TDS. A good TDS for dairy animals is less than 1000 milligrams per liter. D. Compound. You can create a compound of chain link or concrete wall, but the compound wall of the concrete may be costly and you cannot alter the setup later on. In case of chain link, they are attached to metal pillars and they can be shifted and altered to suit the growth requirement of your farm. While putting chain link, it always has to be put from the inner side so that when a cow accidentally pushes the chain link, the pressure falls on the pillars. If you put the chain link from the outer side, then the pressure can break the structure. You can keep the height of the chain link up to 5 to 6 feet. You should have a gate through which you can take the manure outside. E. Compartments. For managing the farm better, you will need to categorize the farm into different compartments as per the age, weight, and stage of the animal. When you have compartments, then you can feed specific group of animals and provide nutrition as per their requirement. In every compartment, you have to provide sufficient space as per requirement and avoid overcrowding. Cows need some minimum distance between each other to lie down, stretch, etc. If this is not provided, then social stress may occur, leading to aggressive behavior and injuries. For adult animals, you have to provide 200 to 250 square feet space per animal. For calves below 6 months, you have to provide up to 100 square feet, and for heifers, you have to provide 100 to 150 square feet. Remember, calves are your assets, and if managed properly, they will help you in making your farm profitable. Within 12 to 14 months, calves get matured into heifers and are ready to give milk at 18 to 24 months of age, and hence they need to be taken care of. You need to take steps so that there is no loss of calves at your farm. Compartments need to be separated by pipes or chain link. You have to provide a minimum of 2 water troughs for each compartment. You can categorize the compartments such as for early lactating animals, dry animals, calves and heifers. In a farm for 20 animals, you have to keep the sick animals in a separate space and also create some space for delivery of calves, which is also called as calving pain. You also need to create a separate compartment for sick animals and calving pain. You should provide each compartment with a grooming pillar. You can take any thick piece of wood which is 5 to 6 feet above ground and fix it firmly on the ground. Over this piece of wood, you can tie ropes by encircling it, or you can also use a brush or a rough plastic mat. When animals rub any part of their body on such brushes, it is called as grooming. It is very important, because of which blood circulation in the body improves. dirt and parasites on the skin get removed, and it reduces the stress of animals.